Yes, good morning children. We'll continue the class now. In the previous class we saw about the length and the unit of its length. Now next we are going to see the mass. Mass and weight. Now the mass is a measure of the amount of the matter in an object. So it is a amount of matter in an object. What is mass is called as the amount of matter in an object. Now weight. Weight is a gravitational pull experienced by the matter. Weight is a gravitational pull, that is a heaviness. Gravitational pull, otherwise called as the heaviness of the matter. So we are going to see the mass and weight now. Now for example, you hold a sheet of paper in one hand and a book on the other hand. Now which is heavier for you, paper or a book? Book is heavier. So the book is more than that of the single sheet of paper. So the pull on the book is more than that of the paper. So the hand has to give more force to hold a book than a paper. So this is called as the heaviness, that is gravitational pull or the heaviness. Now for example, on moon if you take, there is a gravitational pull that is lesser than the earth. So the gravitational pull is lesser than the earth on the moon. Now the weight will reduce but the mass will remain the same of an object. If you keep an object on the moon, what happens? The weight reduces but the mass which is there in the object remains the same. Now the gravitational pull is 1/6 of the earth's pull. Now the object weight 6 times lighter on the moon than on the earth. So it is 6 times lighter on the moon when compared to the earth. Now we will see the SI unit of mass. Now the SI unit of mass is kilogram. What is called as a kilogram? Now it is represented as kg. So what is that? SI unit of mass is kilogram and it can be represented as kg. Now a question, what is it? Now you can ask, what is your mass? So you measure it in grams. For example, 40 kg, 50 kg, like that. So our mass is, it is represented in grams. Now that would be in a huge number, is it right? Yes. So it should be expressed in kilograms. So our mass, it should be expressed in the kilograms. Now bigger weights are also measured and it is expressed in tons. So bigger weights are measured in tons or metric ton. So this is a bigger weights. So bigger weights are measured in tons or metric tons. Now we'll see now, that is units. 1000, milligram is equal to 1 gram. So 1000 milligram is equal to 1 gram. Now 1000 grams is equal to 1 kilogram and 1000 kilogram is about 1 ton. So this, so we will see once again, 1000 milligram is 1 gram. So then 1000 gram is 1 kilogram and 1000 kilogram is about 1 ton. Then next we are going to see the beam balance. So this is a beam balance. Now we can use this beam balance to measure the mass, that is the matter of an object. Now this beam balance works by comparing the mass of an object to a known mass. Known mass is a standard mass. So we can compare it by using the mass of an object to a known mass or the standard mass. So for this beam balance is used. But nowadays electronic balance is used. So this electronic balance we can see in provisional shops or in jewelry shops like this, so and so. So this electronic balance is used nowadays. Then electronic balance is used to measure the accurate weight. It is used to measure the accurate weight of an object. Now this you can see in the laboratories for weighing the chemicals, and you can even see in the electronic balance can be used to weigh food and then grocery items as well as the jewelry. So this electronic balance is used to measure this. The next is time. So everybody knows what is time. So day changes into night, night changes into day, and even seasons also change. But everyone knows what is time. So everyone's house you have clock. You can see the time, you can note the time also. So you know what is the time. Now, so in those days there were no clocks or no watches, but in earlier days people used sand clock or sun dial. So in those days people used to see in this sand clock. So this is a sand clock. People in those days used to see the time, passage of time during the day. The time taken is used to measure the device. It's used as a measuring device. Now you can also have a counting passage of time. We can use electronic clock, that is now stopwatch, and other instruments to count even smaller duration of time. So in those days people use sand clock or sundial, but nowadays all are using the stop clock, watch clock, everyone is used everything. Now children, the lesson is over for you all. Now first we'll revise this lesson again. So I'll write down some important answers on the board. You take down in your rough notebook, children. First we'll see the measuring tools. Take down in your notebook, children. That is measuring tape to measure the length of the distance. Next is stop clock. Measure the accurate time. Next, measuring jar to measure the volume of liquid. Then balance. To measure the mass of an object. So this is an important question. Take down in your notebook, children. So first is a measuring tape to measure the length of the distance. Then stop clock, I said as usual, to measure the accurate time. Then measuring jar to measure the volume of the liquid. And balance to measure the mass of an object. So take down this in your notebook, children. Next, unit of length. Unit of length. Take down this in your notebook, children. Have you all taken down? Next, we'll go to the unit of length. So now, one. What is a scale? Kilometer. Now, 1 kilometer is 1,000 meter. Yes. The next is 1 meter. It's equal to 100 centimeter. So cm stands for centimeter. The next 1 centimeter. That is 10 mm. Mm stands for millimeter. So 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, and 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Take down this in your notebook, children. You should be thorough with this. The next is SI units. So already what I said is, what is SI unit? International System of Units. So what is SI unit? International, what is this? International System of Units. SI system. Yes. Now SI unit for length is meter. What is the SI unit of length? Meter. Then for mass is kilogram. Then unit for time is second, and for area is square meter, and for volume is cubic meter. So what are the SI units? For length is meter, mass is kilogram, time is second, and for the area square meter, and for the volume cubic meter. Have you all taken down, children? Yes. Take down this question, children. What is children, till you get the book, you can learn in this notebook itself what you are writing. Okay, so what is measurement? The comparison of unknown quantities with some unknown quantities is known as measurement. So what is measurement? So the comparison of unknown quantities with some known quantities is known as measurement. Now what is length? The distance between one point and the other point is called as length. So what is length? The distance between one point and the other point is called as a length. So what I have written on the board, be thorough with this children, okay?